Okay, so this is a review of Chapter 5, Phase 2. Number 1, minimum setbacks and building coverages are most commonly found in a zoning bylaw. True or false? We just did Chapter 5.
Minimum setbacks and building coverage. True.
True. Yeah, that's right. It's absolutely true. Number 2, requirements concerning non-conforming structures, non-conforming uses are outlined in the Ontario Building Code. Is that where you'd find it?
No, you'd find it.
No, you wouldn't. That's right. You find a zoning bylaw act. That's right. Yeah. So that would be false. Number 3, an inspector is permitted to enter onto the land subject to a building permit at reasonable times for inspection.
True.
That's absolutely true. The Ontario Fire Code applies only to new residential construction. Does it? Only to new buildings?
Not to everybody.
Not to old buildings?
Yeah, it does.
It does.
To everybody.
Everybody. So that would be false. So it applies to everybody. Number 5, a regulated area for purposes of a conservation authority can be generally described as lands adjacent to a water course that requires special attention owing to various matters, including the potential for flooding.
True.
That's true.
Anything that's that long is going to be true.
Yeah. Well, also because it says here the regulated area can also include areas involving erosion damage and pollution problems, right? That will happen over time. So number 6, floodproofing can be described as either active or passive.
True.
Yeah, that's true.
What active and passive means what?
It means that if it's during a water rise, the sandbagging is one, and passive floodproofing involves construction activity like flood walls, like a dam wall type thing. Number 7, a two-zone floodplain is sometimes used when certain parts of the floodplain are considered less hazardous and development is possible subject to conditions.
True.
That was like our poor credit example, right? So the two-zone floodplain might be used when the floodplain area has a different elevation and varying degrees of risk. So you'll analyze it and see which one is safe or not, what area, what part of it's safe to do on. Wetlands may be eligible for a conservation land tax incentive program. So if you own some property that goes back to the wetlands, you would get maybe a land tax incentive.
Yeah,
yeah, you would, because you can't really use it. Number 9, the Environmental Protection Act, EPA, is a federal statute administered by the Ministry of Fisheries and Oceans.
True.
That's false, because it's actually administered by the Ministry of Environment. Okay? Number 10, the Greenbelt Act protects environmentally sensitive land in Northern Ontario.
Yeah.
It's false, because it's sensitive land in Southern Ontario. Southern Ontario. That's where we are. Like Niagara, Peterborough, all of these parts are...
So Greenbelt is only in Southern Ontario?
Southern Ontario, yeah. Southern Ontario. Mm-hmm. Number 11, a permit is usually required to build a house within the rural areas that are part of the Niagara Escarpment Development Control Area. But do you need a permit for it?
Yeah.
Yes, you do. You do need a permit for it. Number 12, the Oak Ridges Moraine is a low-lying wetland located near Peterborough.
True.
Is it a wetland? Not really. I described it to you. It is actually sandy hills stretching from Niagara Escarpment to the Trent River, which is east of Peterborough.
So it's sandy hills?
Sandy hills. Oak Ridge's moraine is sandy hills. Nothing wet. Okay? And so that answer for 12 would be false.
Okay.